Ubay clings to life in Turkey's southern city, Hatay. Toys are still on his mind. He wants to play, but after each move, his heartbeats begin to fluctuate. His aunt Sarah says Obey's family was hit by the chemical attack in the Syrian town of Hanshehun. His parents are still there, but no one knows where they are being treated.
His condition is unstable. He cries for his parents and brothers. They couldn't come to Turkey. We hope someone helps him to reach his family because he yearns for them.
Dozens of injured Syrians were moved to the border cities of Turkey, but still, there are hundreds waiting to be treated on the other side of the border and recover from the shock.
When we saw the gas, we ran to help people. I saw 3 to 4 who collapsed. Later, I realized there were more than 40 people on the ground. As we searched through, I came across my wife and my children.
In Idlib's hospitals, basic medicine is in short supply.
We don't have enough oxygen and medicine that's needed for these cases. We're not prepared for this. Our medical team doesn't have chemical uniforms or special masks. They had to work with bare hands. We don't even have decontamination tents to wash away the chemicals.
This is not the first time Syrians have buried their loved ones because of a chemical attack. In 2013, almost a ton of the nerve agent sarin was dropped on the rebel-held suburbs of Ghouta near Damascus. It killed at least 1,000 people, again, mainly women and children. Now, as then, UN experts are investigating the Idlib attack, working on forensic examinations of the bodies and planning a trip to the site.
The initial findings indicate a chemical weapon was used against civilians. Turkish authorities say it may have been sarin gas. The Syrian regime denies all accusations, but it will be for The Hague, the Center for Human Rights, to decide. Sinem Koseoglu, Al Jazeera, Hatay.